your cup. Let it overflow. Fill your cup. Hallelujah. You're a living sanctuary. Fill my cup. Sometimes you turn your hands towards yourself. Say, Lord,
fill my cup.
Let it overflow. Glory to God. Can't nobody do you like Jesus? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Let the grown man scream. Glory to God. Can't nobody do you like the Lord can. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Have tears of joy. Make it run, and then the Bible says nothing. People say they ain't nothing chasing you. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm glad to be here today. Saved and sanctified and filled with the precious gift of the Holy Ghost. And do speak in tongues that the Spirit give utterance. Though I testify today. Woo! Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Somebody knew me when I was a child. They said, when y'all were young, y'all used to laugh at the saints. Y'all be laughing at them praising God. They said, now you got it. I said, I got all of it too. Right. Come today. I'm filled to the rim. I'm filled. Woo! Glory to God. I got it. You got to get it for yourself. Can't go on mama's salvation and grandma's salvation. You got to get this thing for yourself. A lot of kids trying to go on their grandma's salvation. You got to get this thing for yourself. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He said, I got it. Somebody said, what day you got it on? A Sunday? Some got it on a Monday. Some got it on a Tuesday. Some got it on a Friday. Some got it on a Wednesday. Some got it on a Thursday. Somebody got it on Saturday. But I got it down on the inside. Woo! Glory to God. The very best Sunday. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Woo! Glory. Somebody say, I feel like running on. The song says, no trials come. I feel like running on. Oh, my God. Somebody said they got on their traveling shoes. Got them on. Hallelujah. I'm ready to run. Ready to run. Glory to God. Oh, I'm ready to run. He said, run on. See, but we know the end going to be. We keep running. We know what it's going to be. But I got to stay faithful until the end. Glory to God. Can't give up, saints. Can't throw in the towel. May go through some difficulty. But we got to hold on. To God's unchanging hand. God will refresh you. He'll renew you. He'll restore you. Whatever you need. Then we're going to go to the word. Whatever you need, God has it. Yes. I used to tell Superintendent, when we talk about David, and when David sinned, and then the prophet came to him and said, if you would have asked me, God told the prophet, tell David. Yeah, yeah. If you would have asked me, God said, I would have did such and such a thing for you. That helped me to know whatever you need, God got it. Amen. Just talk to him about it. Amen. Talk to him about it. He'll work it out. Yes. He'll fix you. He'll fix the situation. Whatever need, God let you know what he's telling David. Let you know, whatever you need, just come and deal with me. Don't you try to do it. Don't you try to make it work out. But come to the Lord. Humble yourself down. And come unto God. And ask God to help you. Say, Lord, if this is the road I got to take, give me the strength. In other words, one preacher said that God will give you the temperament for the task. He'll give you just what you need. Whatever you need, the Lord will give it to you. Amen. That's why you got to stay in your race. Praise the Lord. Woo. Praise the Lord. We're going to the Word of God, 2 Corinthians 4, chapter 8 to the 9th verse again. This is part 2 of never, never, never give up. Never, never, never give up. And some people say giving up is not an option. Not an option. must hold on to God's unchanging hand. He will never leave us, nor fail us, or forsake us. And I'll read the theme scripture again. This is part two of last week. Never, never give up. 2 Corinthians 4, chapter 8 through the 9th verse, read like this. If you have it, read along with it. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Never, never, never give up. As I said last week, never means not ever. So you got to be careful of words you use. Words have power. Life and death is in the tongue. So the word never means ever. So you got to watch what you say. I say never, never give up. Some of y'all encouraged yourself. I'll never be healed. I'll never have nothing. Well, you just told you. You just put it out there. Watch the words you use. But never, never, never give up at any time. Give up means to cease from doing or attempting something or to quit. You can never give up. We are people of the Most High. And we ought to be people that never give up. It shouldn't even be in our vocabulary. Deuteronomy, we don't give up because we got the Trinity, right? We got God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Ghost on our side. And we get all the equipment we need, we can't give up. We won't give up. We loaded down with everything God would have us to be. Deuteronomy 4:31 says, "For the Lord thy God is a merciful God." Did you know he's merciful? He's a merciful God. He's a God that will not forsake thee, neither destroy thee, as he said in Deuteronomy. He's talking to the children of Israel. If we obey God, this is what he's saying to us, neither destroy thee, not forget the covenant of thy fathers, which he sware unto them. Deuteronomy 31:8 says, "The Lord, he it is that doth go before thee. He will be with thee." And I love the next part. "He will not fail thee." Because you got people that will go with you, but they don't got power to accomplish what they need to do. God says, "I won't fail thee. Neither will I forsake thee." I'm not going to turn my back on you. "Fear not, neither be dismayed." Then Jesus said, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I've commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world. Amen. You got the Father, you got the Son, and then we have to receive the Holy Ghost. So then in Acts 1:8, it said, "But he shall receive power." You're not going to give up. You need power. You need power not to give up. Your car won't stop if you don't fill it with gas. And if you got an electric car, you don't plug it in, it's going to give out. It needs power. You need power to survive. That's why many give it up, because you don't have what you need to make it. The Holy Ghost is given to you to get you to eternity. It's your earnest down payment that you're on your way to heaven. But the Bible said in Acts 1:8, "But ye shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you." In other words, God calls you. Jesus saves you, and the Holy Ghost will seal you to the day of Jesus Christ. If you want to be sealed, you got to have the Holy Ghost. When you don't seal, don't put it, don't spoil it on her. It's spoiled and give out. But if you seal it, seal everything in it. Y'all never canned food and put it away, put everything, cooked it, everything in it. Seal it and put it away. And the Holy Ghost will seal you until the day of Jesus Christ. "You shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and all Judea and Samaria unto the uttermost part of the earth. Whosoever believeth that Jesus the Christ is born of God. And everyone that loveth him that begot, loveth him also that is begotten of him. By this wise, know we that we love the children of God." When we love God, we do what? We keep his commandments. We love God and we are part of God and God is in us. We're never, never going to give up. We got to keep God's commandments. "For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous." In other words, they're not something that just burden you down, that you cannot do. God has made it for you. Whatsoever born of God, what? Overcome. outlive the world. If you are saved, if you belong to God, you have the Holy Spirit, the Bible lets you know whatever was born of God. You say you're born again, you repented of your sin. The Bible says you overcome this world. That means you're not giving up, you're not giving in, you're not throwing in the towel, you're not laying it down on the side, putting it on the shelf, but you're going to overcome this world. Why? And this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. We got to have faith in God. And we're not going to give up. Who is he that overcometh the world? But he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God. You believe that Jesus is the Son of God? You got to confess with your mouth, believe in your heart. You believe this, you receive it, you can overcome this world. Because Jesus overcame, and if the overcomer is in you, how you going to fail? You got Jesus, the mother used to sing this song, wrapped up, tied up in Jesus. Now you wrapped up, tied up in Jesus, how you going to fail? There's no failure in God. So you cannot fail. There's no way you can fail. Bible said that it is he that came by water and blood, even Jesus Christ, not by water only, but by water and blood. And it is the Spirit that beareth witness, because the Spirit is true. Well, the Bible said, for there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. And these three are one. If these three are one and they working in you, how can you fail? My God. And there are three that bear witness in the earth, the Spirit, the water, and the blood. And these three agree in one. We got to believe, saints. We cannot give up. Don't give up on your life. Don't give up on yourself. Don't give up on your family. You know, don't curse your family. You know, somebody else, that old boy that don't get up never get saved. We better watch what you're saying. Don't you give up on your family. Don't give up on your friends. Don't give up on your endeavor. Some of you want to do some things. Don't give up, but trust in the Lord. Go after your dreams, after your visions, as I said last Sunday. Go after your goals. Everybody ought to have some goals. You set goals every week and you don't know. Some of y'all set goals and said, at 9 o'clock in the morning, get up and have me a cup of coffee and some buttered toast. You just, that's a goal for you at 9 o'clock in the morning. Don't give up on your goals. You got little goals, you got big goals. Don't give up on your business. Some of y'all got business, no matter how big it is. Maybe like Sister Carter, you work the Avon business, but work it. Don't give up on your business. Work your business. Don't give up on your plans. Don't give up on your miracle. But don't you want God to do it. Don't you give up on it. You done gave up on it and God ain't even answered your prayer yet. I guess he ain't gonna do it. You just keep praying. Like I did. And then when the Lord, after so many years, the Lord did, I said, Lord, you didn't forget about me. Don't give up on your healing. You believe God for your healing, right? You trust in God. Your faith, according to your faith, keep your faith. Believe God for your healing, your deliverance, for it's on the way. I believe it's on the way. Until God say different. Amen. You often hear me say, until God speak to you like Paul and say you ain't going to get it, I'm going to believe I'm going to have it. Amen. But then God told him his grace was sufficient for him, right? Amen. Then if God tell you got to keep whatever you got, then God lets you know his grace is sufficient. Amen. They said, what you walking around here for? You have a disease, but if God said my grace is sufficient, what should have took you out 30 years ago, you'll walk around this mile. They go, how you walk around here? Because the grace of God is keeping me here. Don't give up. If you don't quit, you can endure till the end. The Bible said it shall come to pass. Whatever God says shall, it's gone. When I hear the word shall, I get excited. That means ain't no devil in hell. The gates of hell can't stop what God is going to do. When y'all read the Bible, y'all get excited. That's why you got to stay in the Word. And the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. You and God make a majority. My God, if God shall it shall come to pass, wait on it. Put your foot on it. Say, I believe in God. My God. And let it be like Jesus said, occupy the I come. You got to fight. You got to press on. You got to press through. But the Bible lets us know that all things are possible to them that believe, right? You got to hold on to your faith. Success is for our taking. Giving up is not an option. How much are you willing to give? How great is your faith and determination? You know, when you make up your mind, can't nobody stop. When you really make up your mind, that's what my grandmother told me years ago. She said, it's not hard to live right when you make up your mind. You want to live right. People having a hard time because they haven't made up their mind and want to live right. When you say, I'm going with Jesus all the way, you done made up your mind. Devil, I'm going with Jesus all the way. You ain't going to stop me. You ain't going to block me. I'm going to get what God has for me. So you have to have determination. How far are you willing to go with the Lord for victory? In 2 Kings chapter 13, King Jehoash needed a victory. He went to the man of God, the prophesied, Elijah. He wanted Elijah to prophesy to him so he'd get some help. You read the Bible. Elijah's on his sickbed, but he yet doing the will of the Lord. Some of y'all get sick and say, I ain't prophesying, I'm sick. But if you're a prophet, you still got to preach. Still got to prophesy. You're a preacher. Just because you're sick, you can't stop preaching. He's here. Read your Bible when you're looking there. Elijah's sick now. He's a sick prophet. But the man came to him for a prophecy, a word from the Lord, and he still prophesied. The Bible said, 2 Kings 13, 14 to 19, he said, now Elijah had been suffering from the illness from which he died. He had ended up dying from this disease. Jehoshaphat, king of Israel, went down to see him and wept over him. He said, my father, he cried, the chariots and the horsemen of Israel. Elijah said, get a bow. Elijah said, get a bow and some arrows. And he did so. Elijah said, take the bow in your hand. And he said to the king of Israel, when he had taken it, Elijah put his hand on the king's hand. So he had the bow and arrow, and then the prophet laid his hand on it. He said, open up the east window. Y'all got some east windows in your house? I do. He said, he opened it up, and he shoot. And Elijah said, he shot. And the Lord's arrow of victory went out. The arrow of victory over Aram went out, Elijah declared. You will completely destroy the Arameans in Aphek. Then he said, take the arrows. And the king took them. And Elijah told him, strike the ground. He shoot the arrow. He said, you're going to get the victory. Now he said, take the arrows and strike the ground with them. The Bible said, Elijah told him, strike the ground. And he struck the ground three times. And he stopped. Then the man of God was angry with him. Elijah was angry with him and said, You should have struck the ground five or six times. Then you would have totally defeated Aram and completely destroyed it. But now you will defeat it only three times. What am I saying? Sometimes we stop before the Lord told us to stop. Prophet didn't tell him to stop striking the ground. The Lord didn't tell you to keep on. He tell you to keep on keeping on. But we stop. Well, Lord, I went two times. I went three times. That's enough. But you go till God give you the victory. If he would have kept on striking till the prophet said stop, he would have totally got the victory over his enemy forever. Jeremiah's complaining. Jeremiah 12 said, you're always righteous. You're always righteous, Lord. When I bring a case before you, yet I will speak with you about your justice. Why does the way of the wicked prosper? Why do all the faithless live at ease? You have planted them and they have taken root. They grow and they bear fruit. You are always on their lips, but far from their heart. Yet ye know me, Lord. Ye see me and test my thoughts about you. Drag them off like a sheep that be butchered. Set them apart for the day of slaughter. How long will the land lie parched and the grass in every field be withered? Because those who live in it are wicked. The animals and the birds have perished. Moreover, the people are saying, he will not see what happens to us. Here's Jeremiah talking to the Lord. And the Lord answered him. He said, if you have raced with the men on foot and they have worn you out, how can you compete with the horses? The little thing that God allowed to come your way for a test, you can't even pass them. That's what he's telling Jeremiah. How you going to run with the horses and these little things are taking you down? You complaining about little things. And you got enough tenacity in you. You got enough strength in reading the word to take care of that. How you gonna know with the horses? That's what the Lord said. If you stumble in a safe country, how will you manage in the thicket by joy? God said. Sometimes we're hated. Sometimes we're abused and scorned. Some of y'all, we sing the song we talked about. Short and long. Mistreated, misunderstood. Jeremiah was going through there, but God said, you can't take that little stuff. How you going to run with the horses? How you going to run with the big guys? How you going to handle the big challenges that's coming your way? When we let little things knock us down, because as long as the little things knock us down, we ain't going to get to the next thing. You know, if they say it's a one degree mile an hour wind and you stay at home all the time, what you going to do with a 12 mile an hour wind coming? Lord have mercy. You can't make it. But these things, Lord, we're persecuted. But we must be able to go through with who? The Lord on our side. All of us got different persecution. If we can take the smallest trials and tribulation, the little things that happen to us, we will make it, right? And we learn how to take them, we're going to make it. We don't let them make us give up. We don't get so distressed and discouraged under these light afflictions that come our way. The light things that come your way, you can't let everything knock you down. You can't quit church because a light thing came your way. You know, we all want to get saved and it's perfect in us.
I'm saved now.
Ain't nothing ever going to happen to me. But the Lord is on your side. You know that sin's still in the world. So the things going to come your way. We should let the trial of our faith be proven that we can come out of the fire like pure gold. If you don't ever go in the fire, how you going to come out of pure gold? You can't take nothing. How you going to go in and take it? You said, refine me, O God. That's what you ought to do. Lord, I'm in the fire. Refine me, O God. Renew me. Refresh me. Restore me. How can we stand when the big troubles come? The difficulties and the warfare's come our way. And they're coming. We cannot just throw up our hands. Like the little kid. Y'all all have children, grandchildren, niece and nephew. You can't throw up your hands like little kid. You know little kids throw up their hands in a minute. Until you train them and teach them. Say, Mama, I can't put that book on the shelf. You're like, boy, you better put that book on the shelf. You better reach up there and put it up there. Sometimes that's what the Lord got to do to us. You can make it. Get up out of that bed and get going. I'll be with you. And you'll be like the leper. As you will go, and the Lord stripping. He ain't going to strip you in the bed. See, a lot of us will God to strip us. Then with, Lord, if you send it, I'll go. Lord, God said, go, and I'll send it. Go, and I'll heal you. Lord, I'm waiting for you to heal me right now, dog. He said, get up and go. Then I'll heal you. As the lepers were going, they were healed. They should have stood there and said, Lord, you prayed for us, but we don't see nothing leaving. But the Bible said they started going. And as they were going, what? They were healed. God has put a measure of faith in all of us. Some grit and some grace, huh? Mercy and grace that will carry you through. When the enemy comes like in like a flood, the Spirit of God will what? Raise up a standard in us. Y'all believe the word?
Amen.
You got to get the word in you. Let the Spirit lead and guide you in all truth. Lay hold on the promises of God. Y'all not just reading this word and studying this word in Sunday school or Bible class for nothing. You got to get this word deep down on the inside. Huh? Because when your trials come, that's what it's coming after. But if you got the word and you got faith, you can hold on. Because it's coming after your word. Because, you know, the devil coming after you, know he's going to talk to you. You've been serving the Lord for 43 years. I can't believe the Lord let you get sick. I came to Lord to let believe the Lord that you get weak and you're supposed to be a saint of God. And you listen to the devil entertaining it. And say, the devil, get back. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. You got to let the Spirit lead and guide you in all truth. Because your God cannot lie. Satan is the father of all lies. You got to keep your eyes on the prize, right? For the higher calling in Christ Jesus. For in due season, the Bible said what? You shall reap if you what? That means you don't give up. You ain't going to reap nothing if you give up. You're never going to win if you quit. You're never going to get your crown if you quit. Lord, I'm going to quit. I'm waiting for you to come back and give me my crown. He ain't giving you nothing. But you didn't endure to the end. But you got to go all the way. God is on the side of the who? Righteous. Righteous, we run to it. He's a strong tower. We run to him. No good thing will God withhold from them that love him. The Bible says, so as a man thinketh, so is what? He. Philippians 1:13, I can what? Do all things through who? You ever put that in your mind? I can do all things through Christ who what? Strengthening me. There's going to be some challenges in your life. But I can do it through Christ who do what? Strengthening me. Never, never, never give up. So in the text, let me wrap it up. The Apostle Paul is writing about the power of God in ministry. All of us got a ministry. You may not be the pastor. You may not be a missionary. You may not be this or that, but we all got a ministry. Somebody's looking at you. Somebody's watching you. You're influencing somebody that they can receive Christ through you. And he's talking here about the power of God in ministry and living by faith. We got to live by faith, saints. The Apostle Paul gives an account of their patience. You got to be patient. God will teach us patience, right? Amen. Tribulation work with patience, hope, and hope experience, and the love of God is shed upon your heart. God will teach you patience. Wait on the Lord, and he shall strengthen your what? Your heart. Be of good courage. God will teach you how to be patient. You have to be patient. Encourage you under all the suffering that take place. Maybe that's why he chose the fishermen first. Because the fish, you got to be patient. You can't be out there saying, fish, come on. Fish, come on. No, you got to be patient. You got to let it stay in there. Let it bob around. Let the line stay there. You got to be silent. Listen. Can't be making a bunch of noise. Can't be just bobbing, but you got to be patient. Some of you need to pray for some patience. you know your patience. Sure, y'all tell people sometimes. They don't even have to figure out. Child, you get on my last nerve. You need more patience. Lord, have my patience. Encourage under all the sufferings that take place. There's some sufferings that were taking place. There were beatings. Paul experienced beatings. He was in prison. We were talking in Sunday school today. Same thing. Talking about Paul. He was in prison. He didn't do nothing wrong except talk about Jesus. And sometimes you're going through. All you did was talk about Jesus. And the devil said, I'm going to throw a lash on you. But you better know your God can bring you through. Sometimes he got death. Sometimes he mistreated, ridiculed. Paul knew these things. Sometimes you scorned, and the list goes on. You read the story of Paul and took them 39 lashes, 40 a kill. You took 39, 40 a kill. One more, it would have killed him. But God strengthened him, read the Bible, got up and came alive. Should have been dead. God will bring you through when you do it for Christ's sake. The apostle suffered as a savior. The apostle suffered because their master Jesus suffered. Leader Jesus the Christ suffered. In other words, the Bible said what? Arm yourself what? Likewise. Put on the same thing. Take up your cross, Jesus said what? Follow me. We sing that song, but we really ain't ready to take up our cross and follow me. You're going to bear some trials and tribulation in this life. But listen to what the overcomer says. The victorious one says, whose report will you believe? Your faith is under attack. Yes. Jesus Christ had told them in this world, what? You're going to have tribulation. Yes. Jesus told them that. This is the word of God. John 16:33, he said, I have told you all this so that you may have peace in me. The Bible said, God will keep you a perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee because you trust in him. The Lord wants you to have peace. Peace I give to you. Peace I bring to you. When the angels come, they said, peace. The Lord said, peace be still. Let the Lord fight you. And stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. Here on earth, you will have some trials and some sorrows. Y'all, everybody in this church can raise their hand. You done had trials and sorrows. You done had some things come your way. But take heart, because Jesus already overcome this curse. God will give us help. Do y'all believe that?
Oh, yeah.
He'll send us help. The Bible said Jesus is the very present help in the time of trouble. He will give you great relief. Though we may be afflicted on many ways, we may be afflicted. Some of y'all dealing with sickness in your body right now. Some of you got trouble all around. Some of your kids in trouble. Some of you know somebody in trouble. Things are going on. We may be perplexed. Things are sometimes uncertain. We don't know everything, do we? We don't know what tomorrow holds, but we know who holds the future. There's some doubt. There's some anxiety that come our way because we're human. There's the flesh side. We're not in despair because we can look to the healer. Well, when you don't get in despair, then you can look to the healer. From whence coming your help? All your help coming from who? From the Lord. All our help comes from the Lord. God will help us. Look to the Lord. Tell your issues about your God. Tell your issues about your God. When we're perplexed, remember that God is bigger than every situation and circumstance, and God will help us. He will deliver us. He will bring us out. He will support us. He will make a way for us. You got to put your total trust in God. And then we say it, and we, God make us live. We've been saying it to people, but God will make us a living testimony. That you say, I know what I'm talking about. I know God will bring you out. I know God will heal your body. I know God will make a way for you. I know God. I know God will heal. Anybody know God will heal today? I know God's a healer. He will deliver you. He'll make a way for you. You got to put your trust here. When family and friends sometimes reject you, evil all around you. We're dealing with hatred in the world. We're dealing with envy and jealousy and selfishness and self-righteousness. But if God be for us, he's more than the world against us. The water won't drown you. The fire won't burn you. The witch can't hex you. The poison won't kill you. You belong to God. Let fear go. So God allowed Paul to write to 2 Timothy. He said, God has not given us a spirit of fear, because fear has torment. You don't want to be in fear. You don't want to be timid in fear, but you want to have power. And you get power from God. Love and self-discipline. Love, power, and what? Sound mind. Sound mind means self-discipline. You got to discipline yourself. You can't be all over the place. You got to discipline yourself. So I'm going to stay on course. In other words, that's what Job was saying. Though he slay me, yet will I trust him. I'm going to keep praising him. I'm going to keep praying to him. I'm going to keep doing what I know how to do. I'm going to keep doing what brings results. I know what God will do. Ooh, God is promising, and God cannot lie, and he shall not lie. Deuteronomy 31 and 8 says, the Lord, it is he that doth go before thee, he will be with thee. He will not fail thee nor forsake thee. So we got to put our trust in the Lord and say, let me wrap it up today. Praise the Lord. Since we have mercy from God, we don't get discouraged that we can make it. But we got to learn how to encourage ourselves in the Lord. Somebody may not be around to pat you on the back. And your friends may be against you, like David was when they saw their kids gone and been kidnapped and taken away to the enemy's camp. But you got to encourage yourself in the Lord. God, you heard what they said, but I put my trust in you. Glory to God. I know they're trying to take me out, but I trust in you. That if God can do anything, he can do everything. There's no secret to what God can do. Is there anything too hard for God? Whose report are you going to believe? I'm going to believe the report of the Lord. I'm motivated to do the will of God. I've been here. Mankind may not always pray, but the Bible tells us we ought to always pray and not faint. Don't lose heart in what you're doing. The enemy wants you to stop praying, wants you to stop testifying, wants you to stop living for the Lord. But don't lose heart in what you're doing. on the cry, and the Bible tell me to set my affections on things above, where rust doesn't come in and destroy it. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Keep your eyes on the Lord. Keep on looking unto Him, who is able to heal you, able to save you, able to make a way for you. Paul said in the Word, with trouble on every side, every time I come home from work, I hear all kind of bad news on the TV, on the internet, with pressure in every way, but I'm yet not distressed. I'm not crushed. I'm not broken. You might be perplexed, but I'm finding my way out, because I'm depending on Jesus. I'm not in despair, but I'm running for the Lord. I'm doing what God has called me to do. Sometime the road gets dark, the road gets snowy, the road gets heavy, but God is able to help you to drive through the storm, drive through the rain, whatever you're going through. Saints of God, today I want you to know that God is on your side. Don't you give up. Keep the faith. You gotta have faith in God, faith in Jesus, faith in the Holy Ghost. And if God, read your Bible and believe the Word of God. If God raised Jesus from the dead, He got all power, and that power that Jesus raised from the grave with, and that power work in you, there's nothing that God cannot do in your life. You gotta have hope in a resurrected Jesus. I got hope in the Lord. I'm rooted, I'm grounded in Jesus. I pray every day, Lord, keep me rooted and grounded in Jesus. Help me to grow as you want me to grow. Somebody better get on praying. Praying to Jesus to keep you grounded in the hope of glory. Keep you grounded in the Lord our God. The glory of the Lord shall be revealed. The church shall be edified. God will be glorified, and the enemy will be horrified. Be cheerful, be glad in the Lord. The Lord will refresh you. He will restore you. He will renew you by the power of the Holy Ghost. Jesus, Jesus, help us, Jesus, in the dying world. We need help. We need help from on high. Won't God do it? Won't He make a way for you? Won't He bring you out? God will save your soul. He'll make you whole again. All things are working together for the good who love God, who are called according to His purpose. Whatever the enemy is doing for evil, God is working it out for your good. Somebody's digging ditches for me, but God's helping me to skip over them. God's making a way for you. God, I'll make your enemy behave. God will take care of you. Won't He do it? God will make a way for you. He's yet doing it, and He's doing it by His power. Thanks be to God, who has given us the victory through Jesus Christ our Lord. There's no failure in our God. We have the advantage. We got God on our side. No matter what I'm going through, I know that the Lord is on my side. I'm on the winning side. I'm going to win every time. God's Word shall prevail. God is able to deliver you from the fiery furnace. Whatever you're going through, God can bring you out. God is able to keep you from falling. The psalmist said, He didn't let my foot slip. He didn't let your back slide. God is able to keep you on the cap. Put your mind on Jesus. He will make a way for you. God is able. that begun a good work in you. He that begun a good work in you, Superintendent Covington, he will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. He'll seal you. I don't care what the world may do. You put your trust in the Lord. Don't you stop losing hope. Don't you stop believing God. Don't you stop hoping in God. Don't you lose your faith. The devil wants you to lose your faith. But I got faith. I got faith. The Bible says, have mercy, see faith. And you can speak to those mountains and they'll be removed. God, give me faith. Jesus is interceding for us. Like he interceded for Peter. He said, Peter, I'm praying for you that your faith fail you not. Some of you are going through, and I'm praying for you that your faith fail you not. Hold on to God and never give up. Keep on praising him. When you get up in the morning, say it's a new day to praise him. It's a new day to call on his name. Jesus, I'm calling on you to help. Make it with the Lord on my side. I can go through. I can do it. Help the Lord. Need your help. Sometime, all you gotta do is say, help the Lord. Help me. Help me, Lord. I need more help. I get frustrated. Sometimes you're going through. Say, Lord, help me. Help me to hold out. Let Jesus come. Hold on just a little while longer, but I know everything is going to be all right. Jesus, the Lord will make the enemy's plan. He'll make it fail. He'll make a way for you. He remembers you when others forget. God never forgot about you. What you prayed in 1977, God never forgot what you prayed about. God, if you answered prayer, I remember many years ago when my grandmother had died. God, open up a portal and I can hear my grandmother, the prayer she had prayed. They were raining in the atmosphere and God said, I'm yet answering prayer. They may die on this side, but those prayers keep on living. God, give up. God never gave up on you. Don't you give up. Glory to God. Y'all sing that song, he saved a wretch like me. A wretch is miserable. Messed up. Glory to God. He didn't forget about you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hold on, saints. Hold on, my friend. Hold on. The God's unchanging. Don't you give up. You know, the enemy wants us to give up. Glory to God. He wants us to leave. Glory to God. He'll chase us out of territory we left. You can be in the territory God wants you to be in. The enemy trying to chase you out. Because he don't want you to be there. And though as long as you stay, he can't operate the way he want to operate. He can't do what he want to do. Glory to God. When you praying like you should, the demons can't come in like they want to. They can't get in. But the devil shut down. Glory to God.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. They trying to penetrate and come in. I can't come in.
Right.
My God. Somebody praying in the Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
Shut down. Glory to God. I can't get in. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Trying to take your seed out. But pray for your seed. Pray for your grandchildren, your great grandchildren. Pray for your children. Glory to God. You won't have my seed. Glory to God. Glory to God. Maybe that's you today. You're not saved. You don't have the Lord on your side. You need to repent. No matter how good you are, you still have to repent. Some people think they're going to heaven because they do good deeds. I stay to myself. I don't bother nobody. But do you repent of your sin? Everybody got to repent and become godly sorry. Because all of us were born into iniquity. We're all born into sin. After Adam and Eve. Bible says all of sin that comes short of the glory of God. Nobody perfect. But get saved. Repent of your sins. And let the Lord work on all of us. And perfect us daily. Daily shall I worship thee. The Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. Forgive me of the wrong I've done, the wrong I've been. I believe that you are the Son of God. I believe that God raised you from the dead. Now, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me of my sins. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. And I will serve you for the rest of my life. You prayed that prayer, you're already saved. You need to become faithful at your church. Make sure you're connected with a church that preaches the whole Bible. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. That Jesus is the Son of God. Glory to God. Maybe you're sick in your body. We believe the word of God. Effectual fervent prayer of a righteous person availeth much. Call. Pray. Pray without ceasing. They prayed so they got Peter out of jail. Saints got to pray to turn the world around. Turn things upside down. Keep on praying. Glory to God. They prayed so he got released. God sent the angel to release him. God's going to send some angels on your behalf if you don't give up. Don't you give up praying. Glory to God. God's going to release something. Glory to God. Daniel, I heard you when you prayed 21 days ago. But he had to send the archangel. had to send the archangel. The prince of the atmosphere, the devil, trying to stop your blessing, trying to stop your miracle. But delay don't mean deny. So sometimes I pray with the Lord to release those things that have been tied up. Glory to God. The enemy don't want you to give them. But what God, we used to sing that song, what God has for me, it is for me. Can't nobody mess up your blessing but you. I can act ugly all over here all I want. Long as that person that's supposed to get the blessing, as long as they stay on course, they're going to get what God has for them. So don't let nobody knock you off course. Because you can ruin your own blessing. Maybe you need to be healed in your body. We believe again by Jesus' stripes we were and we are healed. We're praying today that God will heal you from the inside out and outside in, from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet, that the Lord will heal you. Believe God today by faith and go see your doctor and see what the doctor says. Glory to God. Let him testify. Let the doctor testify. Because they got the report. I seen cancer 3 months ago. I don't see it no more. I x-rayed you again. Glory to God. Someone say, seeing clearly, we need God to lay his hand on us again. We like the man. How do you see me and I see him as trees? Let me lay hands on you again. You confused. You ain't seeing right. Some of us ain't seeing right. We need Lord to help our vision, our spiritual vision. Give us clarity. The devil have you all jacked up. You got to get in the spirit on the Lord's day. The flesh can't obtain the things of the spirit. You try to figure it out in your earthly mind. You got to get in the spirit of God. And let him work. Let him do it for you. Let Jesus fix it for you. Let him fix your family situation. Let him fix your marriage. Let him fix it, whatever it is. We believe God today. You're not filled with the Holy Spirit. You're saved. You're bent in your seat. You ought to be praying every day. Lord, fill me with the Holy Ghost. See, I want that Holy Ghost they're talking about. I want that Holy Ghost that's in the Bible. Acts 1 and 8, Acts 2 and 4. I want that Holy Ghost. Glory to God. I'm seeking it. Ask, and it shall be given. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and the door shall be open. Glory to God. I'm seeking it. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm going after it. And no good thing will God will hold from you. Look, there it is. Glory to God. God will give it to you. Glory to God. I want the gift. Thank God for the gifts. And the gifts we're going to give. We bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Be blessed. Give the Lord a hand, praise this morning.